Let us see the live tracking screen in the Trakzee platform. The user needs to click on the live tracking option from the side panel. Basically, the live tracking screen shows the live location of the object on the map. Here, the user can use various other functions like object history, add geofences and POIs, add expenses, etc. Let us start with the basic function of object tracking. In the live tracking screen, all the objects in that user will be shown in the object list, which is segregated company-wise. On the top, the number of objects in each status will be shown. Here the user can see how many vehicles are there in each status. For example, in this user, we can see that there are two objects in stop status. In order to show the objects on the map, the text box checkbox next to the object can be ticked. As the vehicles are ticked, they will start appearing on the map. The objects can also be searched from the search bar. Now to go to the live location of an object, the user needs to click on the particular object from that list. The object will now be shown on the map. The map can be zoomed in or zoomed out by using the mouse, or the user can use the zoom out and zoom in button. For detailed information on the object, the user can click on the object on the map. This will open the object tooltip. Here, the details of the object like its GPS status, its ignition status, power and air condition status will be shown. Below that, the current odometer reading of that object will be shown. Other details like the IMEI number, the device name, the driver information and the number of alerts generated for the object will be shown. The driver mobile number is also displayed and the user has an option to send an SMS to the driver mobile number. If the user wants to add geofences or POIs, the user can add them from the tooltip itself. The location of the object will also be shown. If the object is inside a POI, then instead of the address, the POI name will be displayed. Now, if the user wants to navigate to a particular location and needs the directions for the same, then the user can use the navigate button. The user can search for a location from the search bar. The navigate function will show the route to be followed and also the directions will be displayed in textual format. It will also show the distance to be covered to reach the current location and the time taken to cover the distance. Now, the next tab in the object tooltip is the summary tab. This tab summarizes the data of distance and duration of the object. Here, the distance traveled for the day will be shown. Also, the duration for which the vehicle has been in each status will be displayed. The next tab is the sensors tab, where the information related to all the external sensors attached to the object from the object screen will be shown, like GSM quality, external power readings, etc. Now, if the device is an OBD tracker, in that case, the OBD parameter tab will be available. This tab will show the information regarding the OBD parameters that has been sent from the device, like the engine load, engine coolant temperature, fuel pressure, etc. So as we have seen the tooltip, now let us see the functions the user will get from the object list section. As seen previously, here the object list will appear along with the details of object in each status. Next to the object name, the user will be able to see the speed received from the device and its GPS status. Green color marks successful GPS connectivity and red color indicates that the GPS connectivity is not available. On the very top of the object list section, we have an arrow which will expand the section furthermore and display additional information like the duration, which shows the duration of object in its present status, POI, which shows the location of the object with respect to POI. It will show the POI name if the object is in the tolerance of that POI. Location. This column will show the live location of the vehicle. Next, there are information like GPS, external power, ignition, air condition, and driver allocation information. There is also a column which displayed the health monitor in case of OBD devices. When clicked, it will open a small window which displays the fault code or the issues which has been sent from the OBD device. The next option which we have on the object list panel is the options button. Here the options in this are show history. This option is used if the user wants to check the playback for the object. It can be viewed for any time duration that is selected. When the user clicks on today, a new window will open which will show today's playback of the object. It will show the route which has been followed by the object on the map. It will show the start and end points of the route, along with the total number of halts taken, if any. When clicked on the halt points, a pop-up window will be shown which displays the information of how much was the halt duration and other information like the reach and depart time of the object at this point. It will show the maximum speed reached by the object by the time it reached this point. The user also has an option to add the geofence or POI from this option as well. Now, in the bottom, we have four different tabs. The first tab is the speed tab. In this tab, we get the graph which shows the data of speed versus time. The user can click on various points on the map on the graph. There is also an option to zoom in to the graph by selecting the area. If the zoom has to be reset, then the reset button can be used. Above that, there are buttons to scroll right and left of the graph. Here, the user can select if the stoppage points needs to be shown or not. The user also has the option to select the duration of the stoppage to be considered from the drop-down list. The next option the user has is the speed option. Here the user can decide if he wants the distance traveled at some particular speed to be highlighted. For example, if the speed is set as greater than 20 km per hour, then the distance traveled at a speed more than 20 km per hour will be shown in red. Next, we have the alerts option. Here the user can decide if the alerts are to be shown on the playback path or not. The user also has an option to view only the specific alerts which are generated. Then there is an option to view or not view the route. The next option is to view the data points on the map. Data points are basically the points at which the data has been received from the device. If the data points are enabled, then all such points will be visible along with the playback route. The user can click on any such point and the details like the vehicle status, its speed, distance covered, and the location related information will be shown for that particular data point. The user will also get an option to add geofences or POIs at that point. Finally, the playback can be seen by clicking on the play button. it can be paused by clicking on the pause button, and the speed can also be adjusted. The next tab in the playback window is the data points tab. Here the user can see the details based on the data which has been received from the device. For each data, the user can see the status, its time, latitude and longitude related information, the speed and distance covered for each data along with the location. The user can click on any data point and it will be plotted on the map. The next tab is for the image gallery, where the images which are captured by the camera attached to the GPS device during the playback can be seen. The next tab is for TPMS. Here the user will be able to see the graph of tire pressure and temperature versus duration. It can only be seen in case if the tire pressure management has been done. Now let us see the other options that are available in the live tracking screen. We have the show path option. This option will show the path that has been followed by the object. Here again, the data points will be visible on the screen, and the status, time, latitude and longitude, speed and distance, and the location related information will be shown. In the show path option also, if clicked on a certain point, it will be plotted on the map, and the details like the status, speed, distance and location related information will be shown. Here also the options to add geofence and POIs are available. The next function is the follow option. As of now, in the live tracking map, a user can track the movement of only one vehicle. But if the user wants to track the movement of multiple vehicles simultaneously, then the follow option can be used. When clicked on the follow button, a small window will be opened showing the live location of the object. In the window, the latest data updation time of the device will be shown. The size of the window can also be changed as per the requirement of the user. The window can also be minimized and then maximized. At a time, four objects can be followed simultaneously. The next option is share. Using this option, the user can share the live location of the object. A new window will be opened and the options available in that window are validity. Here the user can decide the validity of the link which is shared from the drop-down. The link will be used to track the location of the object, and the tracking can be done only for the specified duration. The user can specify the email address or the mobile number on which the link needs to be shared. The next option is add expense. This option can be used if the user wants to add an expense related to fuel or maintenance. From the new window which is opened, the user can select the expense type. It can be fuel or maintenance related expense. If selected as fuel, the user will have to select the fuel station from the drop-down list. If the fuel station is not available in the list, it can also be added with the add new button. While adding the new fuel station, its name and description needs to be added. Next, we have the filling type, whether the fuel filling was partial or full. After that, the user has to enter the filled up amount of fuel. Then the amount for which the fuel has been filled needs to be entered. Then the odometer reading at the time of fuel filling has to be entered. Please note that the service reminders will be calculated based on this odometer reading. Next, we have the option to enter the date of the event. Here also, Kindly note that this will affect the service reminders which might have been set for the object. And finally, the description can be entered if needed, and the user can add the expense by clicking on the Save button. Similar to fuel, if the expense type is selected as maintenance, then the maintenance type needs to be selected, and other information like the amount, odometer reading, date of event, and the description can be added if needed, and the expense can be applied by clicking on the Save button. The user can even see the historical expenses by clicking on the History button. Next, we have the Find Nearby object. Using this option, the user can check if there are any objects or POI nearby to the selected object. The user can select if the target entity is an object or a POI. Then the user can set the radius which needs to be checked for the target entity. If any object or POI is found within the radius, then it will be shown on the map. The next option is the driver allocation. If any drivers are already added to the platform, then they can be allocated to the selected object by selecting that driver from the drop-down list. If the allocation is correct, it can be saved. The history of drivers allocated to the object can be clicked by seeing the history option. The user can also select the duration for which the report has to be generated. Next, if the object is having a tire management, then the tire pressure can be seen. Here, the tire number, the pressure, the temperature, and the battery voltage for each tire can be seen. Next, we have the Show Camera option. If any images are captured by the camera attached to the GPS device, then the live image would be shown in the pop-up window. Next, we have the Show Log option. The Show Log option will show the data which has been received from the device for the day. It will show the latitude, longitude, data actual and received time, its data string along with the status. The user can download the report in XLS format. The user can also set the duration for the report by selecting the date range. And finally, if any video related device is added to the GPS device, then the live video can be seen. Now let us see the other options that are available on the live tracking module. The user can select the map type according to their preference. The user can show or add new geofences or POIs. The user can decide if the street view has to be seen. If the live tracking needs to be shown, then it can be toggled by showing the live track option. If the user wants to show the object label at all times, then the Show Label option can be used. And finally, we have the Measure Distance and Areas option. Here we can create a new measurement based on an area which we select. The user just has to select the points for which the area calculation has to be done. And when the measurement is finished, it will show the area and the perimeters for that particular selection.